Hey guys, I gotta do something for you. This time I'm going to review the Sony XA1. Yes, I promised to review the Huawei's MediaPad M3, but I decided to put this video first simply because this device is actually pretty interesting. More onto that later. But first, let's take a look at the specs. The XA1 is not a powerhouse. It is rocking a MediaTek Helio P20, a Mali-T 880MP2 GPU, 3GB of RAM, and 32GB of storage. The rear camera is 23MP with aperture 2.0, and the front-facing camera is 8MP f2.0. At the top of the device, you can find the 3.5mm headphone jack. At the bottom is the Type-C USB port and also the speaker. On the left is the dual SIM tray and micro SD slot that extend up to 256GB of storage. On the right, you can find the volume button and also the power button. This is not the power button with a fingerprint scanner, so you don't see that feature on this phone. On the front is the 8MP selfie camera and also a 5-inch IPS LCD display. And we're going to talk about that later. So the design, as you can see, very Sony, very Xperia. Although housing a 5-inch display, this is not a compact phone. By putting an iPhone 7 Plus next to it, you can see it is a touch slimmer than the iPhone. But the sleeker design is actually making a great difference. More onto that later. And comparing this to the S7 Edge, it is roughly about the same size, also a little bit sleekier. It is having a roughly similar thickness to the iPhone, which is about 8mm. So if you're looking for something that is as compact as the iPhone SE, you have to look somewhere else. So this is not the bezel-less smartphone that we're talking about nowadays. It has a big forehead and big chin, but bezel-less on the left and right. It has a plastic body instead of a metal body, but it doesn't feel cheap at all. So this is a very love-it or hate-it relationship. But single-hand using experience is very enjoyable on this phone. Speaking of experience, the 5-inch IPS LCD display is housing a 720p resolution, which doesn't look very spectacular on the book, but the experience is actually pretty good. The color is good, the brightness is good, so you won't encounter any problem in playing your favorite games or reading your favorite books or watching your favorite movies at all on this phone. If you're skeptical about 720p resolution, take a look at the iPhone. The phone ships with Android N 7.0, which is not the newest on the market. I don't quite understand Sony here. But still, the Android N is a very good experience, very smooth, there's no visible laggish or hanging or whatsoever. So if you look at all the specs separately, this is not a very powerful phone. What it is instead is a phone that has everything put together reasonably. 720p resolution, 2300mAh battery, and Helio P20 chipset, they all look weak separately on the book, but combining these together with the Android N, it won't disappoint you at all. Because it's 720p, it won't overload your CPU. Because of the P20 CPU, it won't be a battery drainer. Because of 720p, running games isn't a problem, so simply saying this phone has many things done right when put together. What feels unreasonable here is the speaker. Instead of front-facing stereo speakers, it opted for a downward-facing speaker that the quality is just meh. The camera quality here is actually pretty decent. Sony is using the Xperia Z5 camera here. Being a once flagship camera, it has pretty much what everybody else have. It is not a very powerful camera, but with proper tweaking, you can actually take some very good pictures here. This picture is taken with the auto mode, and this one also with the auto mode. But also you can make some funny pictures using the AR effect, like this one, and also this one. However, it struggles very much at low light performance. But the camera still has its potential. Using the Google Camera app, you can produce some fine quality lens blur effect. Video quality though, is disappointing. It supports maximum of 1080p recording. There is no video stabilization or whatsoever, but it is not something that I would like to use. So up till now, if you're still considering why this video is a surprise, it's because this phone is actually a budget smartphone. On Amazon.com, the unlocked phone cost $299, but from where I bought this phone, it roughly exchanged to $240 only. Yes, you can find phones that has better price, same performance, or better performance, same price on the market. It is not a very powerful phone, nor it is as compact as the iPhone SE. What it is a phone that has all the hardware and software reasonably put together, but also giving out a very Sony Xperia design character. I am not a Sony fanboy. In fact, I don't like their past phones at all. But this phone is different from the rest of the Sony lineup. Once you've tried or used this, you will understand what I mean. This phone is a very good example of not judging the book by its cover. If you're looking for a budget phone with good design, this is a solid choice. Okay, this is a solid choice too. I'll look into that, I promise. Once again, thank you everyone for watching. I'll see you all next time.
Oh look, I got a lot of stuff. I'm so cool. I'm your new god. Ooh.